Hey, I'm Taylor Swift, and I'm going to be sitting down with Alessia Cara to talk about her album Know It All, which I have heard, and you should buy. Okay, so I hear that there's sort of like a story about how your mother was very cunning and mischievous.
Yes.
And tricked you into singing for her.
So I got in the closet, and I was like, hey, you have to close your eyes, and I'm going to go in the closet, and I'm going to sing for you. But you have to promise me before I sing that you can never, ever make me sing again. Like, you're never going to ask me to sing again. And she was like, I promise. I was like, okay. So I sang for her, and then she started crying, and she's like, oh my gosh, you're going to do it. Like, you're going to do this. I just feel like you're just going to be, like, successful. I just feel it. This is what you're meant to do. And then I was like, okay, Mom, but you have to promise me not to ever make me sing again. And she was like, yeah. And then from that day on, every chance she had, she made me sing in front of family members, in front of friends. She betrayed me, and I hate it. I was so mad at it,
it's
but
cold.
I feel like it helped, though.
I think it helped.
It did. But at the time, I was
cold,
like,
hard betrayal.
And then YouTube happened.
YouTube happened when I was 13.
So did you start your channel by yourself and you just started making videos?
Yeah, that's kind of what happened. I didn't have originals. I didn't even start writing music until.
So you played instruments.
I had played a guitar. That's all I really
and
knew
ukulele.
How to play. And ukulele now.
Which is so cute.
Thanks, I know. It's fun. Started posting covers of other people's songs, just songs that I liked. And the weird thing is, like, it took like 3 or 4 years for me to actually get noticed. Like, nobody would watch my covers. I would just kind of do it anyways, except for friends and family. But as I progressed, I think I started getting more views, and it just took this one time when I was 16, I posted this cover of this song called Sweater Weather by The Neighborhood. And this girl found me, and she was this A&R at this production company. She just stumbled across the video, and she was like, well, we need to get in contact with this production company, and they're called EP Entertainment. And long story short, they got in contact with me and my dad, and they flew us out to New York, and I sang for them, and it was like this whole amazing thing, and it was like my first time really being out doing anything with myself for music, and it was just really cool experience, and it happened really fast. But I feel like the development process, like, is the part that took a while, like that in between, almost like music purgatory kind of took a while.
But that's probably why you're so good. Okay. Honestly,
I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful that I had that time to develop and make this album before I even was signed. A lot of it, like, we wrote before I was even signed.
So when you found the production team and your collaborators, Sebastian Cole and Kuya, who, like, figured out this sound, you found them through Def Jam, or did you find them through your management company?
I found them through EP Entertainment. So Sebastian Cole is another artist signed to EP. He's amazing. And I had never heard of him, I'd never met him before, and they were just like, you think you guys would be good together? Just get you guys in a studio. And Kuya, the producers, were friends, I believe, of Tony and Rob from EP. And they just put us together in a studio just to see what would happen. And I wasn't even signed to the production company at the time either. I was just like testing the waters. And I was doing this after school. Yeah, I would go after school and just start.
Double life. I
relate
to that so much.
I know, we were talking about that too. You just like, I didn't want to tell anyone at school what was going on. So I just sneak off after school, go to this studio in Toronto downtown and just make these songs. And I didn't even know that I was making my album at the time, which is kind of cool.
So one thing that I think is really interesting about this record is that it feels really fresh. Like, a lot of your stuff is very rhythmic, and it's very, like,
words.
It's all about cadence, and it's very poetic. And so I was wondering, when you write a song, do you start an idea on guitar and bring it to Sebastian Cole and Kuya, or do you go in and they play you a track and you write over it?
You know, it's kind of weird. I think the process was always different for each song. It was like, either we started with a chord, Sebastian would play, because he plays instruments as well, so he'd either start with like a piano chord or a guitar, or I'd come in with like a topic idea, like a concept. Like, I don't know what I want to say, but I know I want to talk about this. Or they would play a track. It was always kind of different, but I feel like now when I do it, because we wrote this album like 2 years ago, like half of it started like 2 years ago, so it was a while, and I feel like my writing style changed. And now when I do it, it's definitely like with a guitar, or I try to make beats now. I'm a producer as
really?
Well now. Yes, I'm trying.
Sick.
On a laptop, I'm really trying. So I just like put together a really crappy beat with crappy chords, and then I sing over that and try to come up with
that's
melodies.
That's amazing.
Thanks. I'm really not good at it, but I'm hoping to be one day.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
Know It All as a concept, I didn't know, I didn't really know anything about the record when I heard it, but I realized when I listened to it that Know It All is a lyrical concept, and it goes throughout the entire record. There's not one song on the album that strays from that concept.
Yeah.
Even when you're singing a love song like I'm Yours, which I'm obsessed with.
Thank you. Yeah, I know. I saw you tweeted. It was amazing.
Love that song. But anyway, that song is like, it's romantic, and it's beautiful, and it's vulnerable, but it's also like, I know about this. Love gets you hurt. that's why I don't want any part of this.
Exactly.
But it's happening anyway.
Exactly.
It's all it's all very much like, I'm very aware of what's happening, and that goes throughout the entire record.
Yeah, it kind of does. It's weird. I think I noticed that after, when everything was all done, I was trying to see, like, what is the vein that this whole album goes in? Like, what's the similar concept throughout the whole thing? And I figured out it was that, and it came from a line in my song 17. Yeah, I'm know-it-all, I don't know enough. And I was like, this is it. I'm know-it-all, I don't know enough. That's like, every song on the album talks about that, because there's vulnerability, and then you see, like, at the end, I don't really know much, and I'm vulnerable, but then it has this, like, hard shell of I know what's going on, I know how this goes, I know all about life, you know? But, yeah, so I figured out, it was like a eureka moment, you know?
Was there a moment when you finished a song and you knew that the record was done?
I think when I wrote Four Pink Walls. That's the last song I wrote, and I did it all by myself at home, and then I went into the studio with just me and an engineer, and we did it, and I was like, it was the first time that I felt like I was taking initiative and doing it on my own, and really, like, just doing it, and it was about me following my dreams and doing all this crazy stuff, so I felt like, okay, this is it, we snuck it into the album, and I was like, it's done, it feels full now,
and then it became the first impression, the EP name.
It did, and I feel like that just, like, I don't know, it just made everything full, and I wanted to tell the story as it was happening. I didn't want to wait to write the song for the next album. Like, I wanted to really say it as it was going on. So I just felt like it needed to be on this album, you know?
Yeah, I agree. Okay. High five.
High five. Hand hug. Hand hug.
What's that? Like this. What is that?
And then you hug your hand.
Oh my god, I'm learning so many
things. I know, right? Come on. In love with it in the